Hi everyone. So in this video we'll be talking about some autoimmune disorders. So first we'll start with Sjögren syndrome. Okay, so what happens in Sjögren syndrome? Here the lacrimal gland and the salivary gland are affected. Okay, or how they are affected? It is damaged due to lymphocytic infiltration. So there is lymphocytic infiltration in and around the glands, okay, and that leads to fibrosis. So consider this is the gland, okay, and there is lymphocytic infiltration in and around the gland which leads to fibrosis of the gland. Okay, what are the symptoms? Symptoms are dry eyes and dry mouth syndrome. Okay, these two together are known as Sjögren syndrome. Okay, so dry eyes and dry mouth together is known as Sjögren syndrome. Now sometimes this Sjögren syndrome is associated with rheumatoid arthritis. Okay, rheumatoid arthritis. So this is cause of secondary Sjögren syndrome. Okay, so when the Sjögren syndrome is associated with rheumatoid arthritis, it is known as secondary Sjögren syndrome. Okay, now what is the diagnosis of your Sjögren syndrome? Okay, so we take some autoantibodies. We see the presence of some autoantibodies. Okay, तो ऑटो एंटीबॉडीज में आता है ANA पॉजिटिव. पॉजिटिव मींस ऑटो एंटी न्यूक्लियर एंटीबॉडीज प्रेजेंट. देन कम्स एंटी रो एंटीबॉडी व्हिच वाज अर्लियर नोन एज SSA एंटीबॉडी, Sjögren सिंड्रोम ए एंटीबॉडी. देन एंटी ला एंटीबॉडी व्हिच वाज नोन एज SSB एंटीबॉडीज. Then also these are the three antibodies: anti-nuclear antibody, anti-Rho antibody, anti-La antibody. Okay, so anti-Rho antibody is associated with vasculitis. Okay, then it is associated with renal inflammation. And it is associated with longer duration of disease. Okay, so anti-Rho antibody is associated with vasculitis, renal inflammation, and longer duration of disease. That's why so patient Rho data hai, like he has vasculitis also, he has renal inflammation also, longer duration of disease also. So this is how we remember. Okay, but still this antibodies are not the accurate diagnosis. For we do not come to accurate diagnosis only through the antibodies. We have to do lip biopsy. Okay, that is the confirmatory investigation of choice. So what do we see in lip biopsy? Consider these are the glands and these are the ducts. Okay, glands, ducts. Okay, so what we see, there is lymphocytic infiltration in and around the glands and duct. Okay, aise dikhai deta hai humko. Theek hai, to this is confirmatory investigation of choice. So what do we see? Lymphocytic infiltration around glands and ducts. Okay, and this Sjögren syndrome patient have increased risk of marginal zone lymphoma. Okay, so we have to remember this Sjögren syndrome patient have increased risk of marginal zone lymphoma. Sjögren syndrome, they have increased risk of marginal zone lymphoma. Okay, So now we'll be talking about systemic sclerosis or scleroderma. Okay? So what happens in systemic sclerosis or scleroderma? There is increased fibrous tissue deposition. Where does it happen? In the skin and other organs. Okay, fine. Now, what are the variants of systemic sclerosis or scleroderma? These are one and the same thing, systemic sclerosis and scleroderma. Earlier name was scleroderma, now it is known as systemic sclerosis. So the variants are linear scleroderma, also known as morphea. Then we have got limited scleroderma, and we have got diffuse scleroderma. So let's talk about each one of them now. So let's start with linear scleroderma. Linear scleroderma, also known as morphea. So in this morphea, what happens? Only one organ is involved, that is the skin. Okay, so MO, mono organ, just for remembering, nothing related, mono organ involvement, morphea. Okay, so there are patches on of hard skin present. Okay, and no other organs are involved. Okay, so this is linear scleroderma. Okay, now we'll go to limited scleroderma. Okay, in this, what happened? Initially the blood vessels are involved, okay, which is known as Raynaud's disease. Then a little later, the skin is also involved, and the skin of which body parts? Fingers, face and forearm. Okay, all FFF. Okay, FFF. So first blood vessels are involved, Raynaud's disease, then skin is involved, and then later other organs are involved. Okay, it is associated with late visceral involvement. Okay, it is associated with late visceral involvement. So in limited scleroderma comes your CREST syndrome. So what is CREST syndrome? Let's write the full form. CREST, CREST, CREST. CREST may C for calcinosis. Okay, R for Raynaud's phenomenon. Okay, E for esophageal dysmotility. Okay, S for sclerodactyly, and T for telangiectasia. Fine. So C for calcinosis, R for Raynaud's phenomenon, E for esophageal dysmotility, S for sclerodactyly, and T for telangiectasia. Fine. Now the limited scleroderma is associated with anti-centromere antibody. Okay, and limited scleroderma has comparatively better prognosis, that is good prognosis. Okay, now we will talk about diffuse scleroderma. Okay, scleroderma, spelling is mistaken, please don't mind. So here the skin is involved and other organs are also involved very early. Okay, so what are the other organs involved? Number one is esophagus. Esophagus, what do we see in esophagus? We see dysphagia. Okay, then we also the GIT is involved. We see malabsorption. Then in cardiac, we see fibrosis. Then in lung, it becomes the cause of death. ठीक है. Now for this diffuse scleroderma shows anti DNA topoisomerase antibody positive. Okay, it is also known as anti SCL70 antibody positive. Okay, so you can remember D for diffuse and T for total organ involvement. Okay, now beside anti-DNA topoisomerase, there are some other antibodies also shown by this diffuse scleroderma. Okay, that is anti-ANA antibody. Then we see anti-RNA polymerase 3 antibody. Okay, so this anti-RNA polymerase, we can remember it with three mnemonics. The symptoms shown there, renal involvement is there, which leads to scleroderma crisis. And for neoplasia is also involved, and there is acute onset. Okay, so this was all about your scleroderma, or that is systemic sclerosis. So we have now discussed systemic sclerosis and Sjögren syndrome. Next we will be talking about dermatomyositis. Let's talk about dermatomyositis. So what happens in dermatomyositis? The derma is involved, that is the skin is involved. Myo is involved, that is the muscles are involved, and some surrounding blood vessels are also involved. It is dermatomyositis. It is primary or associated with cancers. It is associated with paraneoplastic syndromes, or this is a paraneoplastic syndrome, I mean to say. So with some cancers, this is dermatomyositis is associated. So now let's see what are the clinical features. Clinical features of dermatomyositis. Number one, in the skin we see heliotrope rash. Okay, on upper eyelid. Okay, we see some rash known as heliotrope rash on the upper eyelid. Then we also see Gotron papules. Okay, Gotron papules seen on the extensor surface. Okay, seen on the extensor surface. Then about the muscle involvement. Okay, so proximal muscles are involved predominantly. So P for P, proximal predominant. Okay, then distal muscles are involved later. Okay, so what we have learned here, the clinical feature in the skin we see heliotrope rash, then we see Gotron papules, then in the muscle proximal muscles are involved first, and then the distal muscles are involved later. Okay, there is one finding in dermatomyositis which is non specific, that is increased creatine kinase level. There is increased creatine kinase level, but still it is non specific diagnosis. Okay, Now let's talk about the specific diagnosis of dermatomyositis. So it can be diagnosed with the help of autoantibodies. Okay, so number one autoantibodies is anti-nuclear antibody. Number two is anti-JO1 antibody. Okay, then number C is anti-MI2 antibody. Okay, that is also present. Then number D is anti-P155 antibody. In our video on paraneoplastic syndrome, we have talked about this antibody. Then E is anti-P140 antibody. Okay, so now there are specific things to be remembered associated with these antibodies, like aapka jo dermatomyositis hai usme something we need to remember, like the dermatomyositis patients have mechanic hands. That means like the hands are very tough, hands are tough and very rough, tough and very rough. Okay, so that's why it is known as mechanic hands. You have seen the hands of mechanic, it's very rough and very tough. So you can remember it like anti-JO1 antibody is present, right? So JO is a number one mechanic. Okay, JO is a number one mechanic. So you can remember it like that. Okay, then JO1 in Hindi, JO1, how to spell? It's like this, I think, JO1. So in Hindi it's like this, JO1, something like that. So JO1 means the juvenile period, or the not juvenile, the early adulthood. Okay, the youth phase of life. So this dermatomyositis maximally involves the younger age people or the youths. Okay, then, and how to remember anti-MI2 antibody? See, this Joe has an MI phone. Okay, Joe has MI phone. So you can remember it like that. MI is most trending nowadays phone. Okay, after the fall of Nokia, MI is most trending. So then anti-P155 antibody and anti-P140. In my video on paraneoplastic syndrome, I have said that P is for, you can remember, paraneoplastic syndrome. Okay, so now what is the specific diagnosis of dermatomyositis? So it is done through biopsy. In biopsy is the confirmatory diagnosis of dermatomyositis. So what do we see? Excuse me. So in dermatomyositis, what do we see? We see perimycial inflammation. That is, in and around the muscle, there is inflammation. Okay, and in that inflammation, that CD4 T cells are maximally found. Also, we see perifascicular atrophy. Okay, so this was about dermatomyositis. Now let's talk a few points about polymyositis. Okay, polymyositis, what happens in polymyositis? In this, skeletal muscle are involved. Okay, then skin is not involved, no skin involvement. And on biopsy, we find endomycial inflammation. Okay, so we'll be talking in detail about polymyositis in our medicine lectures. So this was all about some of the autoimmune disorders. We have talked before about systemic lupus erythematosus. Now we have talked about Sjögren syndrome, then systemic sclerosis, that is scleroderma, dermatomyositis and polymyositis.